Hey, what's up, guys? Welcome back to Destiny. I am ShadowDragonic, and again, another massive update. As you can see there, my light is now up to 332, which is pretty phenomenal. Not exactly the best, but, you know, it's getting there, slowly. Now, first thing I want to update you guys on is, well, here, we'll travel to the tower. Destiny currently has going on, the Dawning event, which is almost like a Christmas type event, which is pretty cool. Now being that, you know, all this stuff is, like, new to me in general, it's pretty cool that they do these events and stuff for, you know, the MMO type feel, I guess you could say. But we'll travel to the tower, and then I will fill you guys in on, you know, everything that's sort of happened since then, and weapon updates and armor updates and stuff of that nature. Now, I'm hoping things might be running a little slowly. I am uploading in the background as well as, you know, recording this at the same time, so I'm trying to be open-minded here and hope that my software doesn't mess anything up, you know, with everything going on. So yeah, obviously you can tell that the tower is completely different. It is snowing, they have it decorated, it's pretty cool. You can also tell that my armor is pretty freaking badass looking, and completely different. I also have a different weapon on my back. And I will fill you in on that right now. Yes. The weapon that I'm using is the Zalo Supercell, which is an exotic weapon that I picked up from Xur on his latest visit here to the tower. It is not good for PvP, but it is great for crowd control in PvE. So, you know, doing strike missions, stuff of that nature, it is amazing. It is also the only primary weapon with elemental damage on it, which is arc elemental damage. You will not find any other primary weapon with any kind of elemental damage attached to it whatsoever. You can't call the Angel's Advocate a elemental damage. Although, I guess you sort of could. I mean, it's got that explosion in there, so, eh. But they don't consider it, you know, elemental damage, primarily. What else? I did obtain a Tower Watch shell, using my, legendary tokens, or my legendary marks. So that's nice. On top of that, we have the Scarlight Mask, the Scarlight Grasps, the Scarlight Vest, the Scarlight Boots. That's the same. And I got the two-sided coin is something that I found. All of these are obtained, and a lot of you will probably hate me for this, because I said in the very beginning that I was not going to spend money on this game. And technically, I did not spend money on this game. I was given a gift card from work, and I used said gift card to buy some silver pieces. And went ahead and bought some silver pieces and bought quite a few chests from, or whatever you want to call them, the boxes from the Eververse Trading Company. And that is where you get this armor from. As well as that, they also have vehicles. I'll have to show you guys everything that I got, because I pretty much got everything that you can get from, you know, the boxes. With the exception of a couple things. Now, some of the things that I got all this armor, obviously, which has chroma, which is awesome. I put red chroma on all of it. Changed up my paint scheme a bit to make it a little bit better. So it's pretty cool. On top of that, Red Death is now... Now has a different paint job, which is pretty cool. It's now white with, you know, blood spatter. That is due to the White Witch ornament that was gotten. I attached that to it, and yeah, so now it's got the White Witch ornament. And the Zalo Supercell, I got the Shock Hazard ornament for it. So now it looks like this, rather than... It looked kind of like crap before, so... Yes, what else? As well as that, I got a new emote, which is the Thunder Dance, which I enjoy using a lot, actually. I use it every time I pick up a Legendary Engram. I'll just start dancing randomly. It's pretty funny. I got the EV44 Firefly, which is probably my favorite, land speeder up to date. Very, very cool, especially while you're, driving it. It changes colors and whatnot. I also got the Bitfire, the EV45 Bitfire, which is pretty cool. Horn, I got a whole bunch of different horns. There you hear it's very dramatic sounding horn. Obviously, it's called the Dramatic Horn. But yeah, all that stuff. And let me show you my box real quick, which is full of all sorts of shit now. I put my Continental away only because I got the other auto rifle. This stuff you've seen already. Armor-wise, as well as the set that I have, there were two sets that you could get armor-wise for this event. The other one is the Snow Angel armor, which I got a full set of that as well. The Cloak of Snows, Snow Angel Boots, Snow Angel Vest, Snow Angel Grasps, Snow Angel Horns. So I have all of that. As well as that, you guys know about my Spectre Grasps. I also got Spectre Boots. Yesterday I played some Prison of Elders and got the Spectre Boots out of that one. Hopefully I'll get a full Spectre set suit. Would be nice. And here we go with all the general stuff, and everybody's probably thinking, oh my god. That was obviously given at the beginning of the game. We have all these different horns now that we can use. House horn, frame horn, bell horn, bellow horn, campfire horn, sparkle horn, remix horn. And we also have lots of land speeders to choose from. The EV-50 Mirage, EV-49 Phantasm, the Prismatica. Now, these are just basic colors. Like the Phantasm and this one, the Lava Bird. And this is just a basic one as well. It's just golden, which is kind of cool, I guess. And this one's pretty basic too, except it's the glimmer gold. I see nothing spectacular about this other than it's an event one that you get that has a snowflake on it. And it's blue. Eh. But we also have the Bitstorm, which is pretty cool. And we also have the Prismatica, which is also pretty cool. All kind of techno themed. But I'm sticking with the Firefly because it is pretty awesome. You also notice I have a whole bunch of freaking chroma now. If I ever want to change up, the chroma on my armor, I can. We also have a shit ton of ornaments for all sorts of different weapons. More chroma. Snowdrag, Fellwinter souvenir. I'm not even sure what they do, honestly. And then we got some Days of Iron ornaments, and yeah. So, lots and lots of stuff. Lots of stuff indeed. So, if you really want to get technical, yes, I did buy stuff in the game. But if you really, really want to get technical, I technically did not. My work paid for it because... It was a gift card, it was gifted to me, it was technically not my money. So, say what you will. My security package. On top of that, let's go ahead and do some stuff, since that was a pretty hefty update. Every day, as far as I know, every day with this event, you can come up here and there are 4 Gifts of Dawning you can open up and they will contain random stuff. So I'm gonna go ahead and do that now. Helium filaments, a strange coin, ooh, an encrypted Engram, and some spirit blooms. Now these ones, it says it requires certain tags, and I'm not sure what you do in order to get said tags, but,
checking for bounties, Guardian.
Hopefully I'll figure it out before the event goes away. What else was I gonna say? Oh right, from Xur, I pretty much spent all of my coins. I mean, I did get some back. Obviously, I have 6 now. I bought the gun, obviously, and on top of that, I also bought 3 of coins. Now, I did some research, and people say the 3 of coins are actually really, really useful and worth it to have. As you can read there, it says, stackable effect that increases the chances the next ultra you defeat or crucible match you complete will award an exotic engram. And like it says there, it's stackable. So you can go ahead and stack all 15 of them, I guess, and pretty much be guaranteed an exotic engram or multiple. A lot of people were saying that if you stack 15, you're almost guaranteed 4 exotic engrams out of the 15 that you stack. So I'd say that's pretty well worth it. I mean, even if I just got, you know, 2 out of it, it would make it pretty worth it. So yeah, what can we do now? Obviously, we have a lot of stuff that opened up off-screen. We now have this Sparrow Racing League that we can do if we really want to. I'm not very good with racing stuff at all. Let's just get that freaking engram encoded while I'm here. Or, you know, yeah, encoded.
These engrams were buried under Hong Kong.
Sure. Done. Whatever.
Oh, I'm sorry to see that one go.
Okay, that was interesting. Obviously, my game is running a little slowly because of the stuff that's going on in the background.
I hope we help, Guardian.
Let's get rid of that because that is garbage. Oh, yes, I no longer get weapons or armor that are uncommon.
So many guardians.
If I get an uncommon engram, it automatically either becomes weapon parts or armor parts, which is nice because then I don't have to just destroy them all the time. I've just kind of reached that high of a level that they're like, okay, well these aren't useful for you at all anymore. I don't even know where I'm going, honestly. Let's go ahead and go to orbit. And we will figure out something to do while we're in orbit. Alright, so let's see. We have a whole bunch of stuff, obviously, that we can do now. Oh geez, I have a message. I didn't even see that. I'll have to look at that then. We can go to the Ocean of Storms moon. We have a Blighted Chalice strike that we can do. We also have... Didn't we already do the Shadow Thief? I could have swore we already did the Shadow Thief. In fact, I'm almost positive we did the Shadow Thief already. Huh. Alright, no matter. We also have... What is that? Shadow Call. Alright, so we have a quest there we can do. It's just a patrol. So we have a single player quest we can do there. We have the Sunless Cell Strike, which we could do on the Dreadnought. That's just patrol. So I guess really we don't have as much as I thought we did. Well, let's go ahead and ascend the Devil's Spire and outrace the darkness that follows close behind. That doesn't sound fun at all, actually. We could potentially start Rise of Iron. I mean, Taken King is pretty much done. We did complete Taken King. We just have, you know, leftover stuff that we can do for the Taken King. So, I'll tell you what. Let's go ahead and get started in the Taken King. In the Fellwinter Peak. King of the Mountain.
In the years after the collapse, the world had no guardians. It had only Iron Lords. Immortal, fearless, we fought to protect the survivors of a once great age. Our battle was about more than crawling back from the shadows. The Iron Lords would give humanity back its future. Legend. But no one truly knows how the Iron Lords died their final deaths. That was something you had to be there for. To witness. To remember. To know even heroes can die. And survival is not always a victory. Now, I am the lone sentry, and my watch is eternal, waiting for the day when whatever we disturbed awakens. The Iron Lords are gone, but our fight is far from over.
The House of Devils is back, and they're digging into old Golden Age research labs all across the system. This isn't a simple smash and grab. They're on a mission. At first, the Vanguard wasn't particularly concerned. At least, not until the Devils decided to move back into the Cosmodrome. Now the Devils are shifting a massive amount of resources to an area nearby that's been dark for centuries. Normally, I'd say it's just another day. Except, what's really got everyone talking is that Lord Saladin has left his post at the Iron Banner to take charge of the situation personally. Only rather than go straight to the Cosmodrome, Saladin wants us to investigate an abandoned observatory in the mountains. Very strange.
Thank you.
A group of Fallen has captured Fellwinter Peak. My team and I are en route, but we won't get there in time. I need you to secure the observatory at the top. It is imperative the Fallen do not establish a foothold on that mountain.
Roger that.
If the Fallen are working their way up the mountain, their goal is to take Vostok Observatory.
What would the Fallen want in an abandoned outpost?
Things better left buried. There is a gondola near your location. Take it up to the observatory.
Because riding a gondola sounds extremely safe right now. Alrighty then. Any kinds of secrets? Maybe. No?
Whoa, this hasn't been activated for more than 400 years.
Yeah, it sounds really safe. I certainly wouldn't trust it. Why is it snowing inside the gondola?
Sort of reception, it might be a touch ambitious to think we can secure the entire observatory.
There's a courtyard in the rear of the facility. If you can secure that, you should be able to keep them from the Iron Temple until we arrive.
Wait, Iron Temple? Like Iron Banner? Iron Lords?
Stay focused. There's too much at stake.
Watch out! Little metal box anymore.
Yeah, I don't like the little metal box either. That's nice.
We can't take another hit like that. Jump!
Okay.
I don't understand. If there's something so important up there, why wasn't the Vanguard protecting the temple all these years?
This place and its secrets are my responsibility.
You know, this is more than a few fallen, just for the record.
We cannot afford even one to claim what lies on that mountain.
Defend the mountaintop. Well, it's gonna be kind of difficult unless they give me some freaking ammo for my damn red death. That works. All right, so Ingram. I didn't even see that drop. Took a little while to pick up too. That's what I was afraid of. It's gonna run a little bit slow because of all the stuff that I have going on in the background with uploads and whatnot. I usually don't record while I'm uploading.
Be careful. Picking something up nearby.
But I have the chance to record. So I'm not gonna let up on a chance to record. What the hell is that?
Wait. Sepik's prime. It's supposed to be dead. And there's something odd in the energy signature. It's not fallen, but it's regenerating.
Did you say it's regenerating? Kill Sepik's guardian. Kill it now.
It wasn't called Sepik's Prime, it was called Sepik's Perfected.
If that's what I think it is, the temple doors will not be strong enough to hold it back. You must destroy it before that happens.
Temple doors are open already, or at least the entrance to the doors are open. Wouldn't be much of a let's play if it ended here, would it? Just want to make sure I'm not forgetting anything or missing anything.
let Sepix enter that temple.
Well, how do you want me to freaking deal with it? He's got a big ass shield around him. Okay. Oh, he doesn't.
Reinforcements approaching your coordinates.
Okay, I think Sepix is dead.
All this trouble to break into an old temple?
Even old wolves still bite. Shiro, what's your status?
Circling around to make sure the area is clear. Be there in a sec.
Well done, Guardian. The temple is secure. Now we can...
Shiro, get a lock on.
I just picked up... Wait, multiple impacts near the wall in Sector 17.
They're attacking the sensor grid. They must know where Siva is.
Guardian, go to the Cosmodrome immediately. If Sepix escapes, the Fallen won't be our only problem.
Alrighty then. Hey look, garbage. Although maybe not. Maybe I could use that helmet to fuse with my current helmet. Okay. 331, 340. Is it really worth it though? 9 defense? I think we'll wait. Right, so now we gotta go back to old Russia Earth. Oh hey, they got this all open up now. The plague lands. The walls come down. The Cosmodrome has been transformed by an ancient threat. Find the source of the corruption. Yeah, I think we got time to do one more. So I still haven't decided yet whether or not I'm going to do some PvP stuff. I mean, obviously I'm going to at some point, but whether or not I'm actually going to record it. I may not. I haven't decided yet.
Lord Saladin, you said the Fallen knew about Siva. but I can't find a reference to SIVA in the Vanguard database.
That's because I went to great lengths to lock it away. The records are in the Iron Temple.
Okay, but if the Fallen already know about SIVA, then shouldn't we?
What you need to do now is track Sepix. If we find him, we will know the extent of the corruption.
Okay, I don't know which scares me more, the giant catch, or whatever took a bite out of the wall.
Guardian, it's Shiro. You're gonna need some cover. Make for the Cosmodrome.
So aren't we just outside, like at the very, where we were at the very beginning of the game?
We need to get through that wall.
Oh hell, we can go to the catch? Or the catch? Is it actually gonna let us on? Shit, it is. I know I'm technically not supposed to be up here, I don't think. I'm going in the wrong direction. But you'd think if I could take out that catch, that would kind of ruin their plans, wouldn't it? Oh, never mind. It's not gonna let me go any further. Fair enough. But I know for a fact it's gonna make us come back here.
Most of the Kells gone, getting a force this large to work together is almost impossible. Saladin, you mentioned a sensor grid. Can we use that to tell how far this occupation extends?
The Fallen are irrelevant, Shiro. The only thing that matters now is finding Sepix.
Follow the signs. Yeah, you'll see in a minute when I pick up that uncommon Engram. It'll just give me freaking parts. There you go. Which, it's nice that the game actually does that, because that saves me, it not only saves me the trouble of having to go into my inventory and scrap all that stuff myself, but it also leaves room freed up for the engrams that I can actually get, you know, decoded. You know, I have to say, as much as I initially hated pulse rifles, and I probably still do hate pulse rifles, this Red Death is just, it's amazing. It really is an amazing weapon. I mean, its headshot ratio is ridiculous. You don't even need to aim on their head and you get headshots. Can't go into the hole.
Lots of fallen, but still no sign of Sepix. What is that pattern over there? Can we take a closer look?
Pattern over where? Oh. It looks like organic machine.
I'm picking up some strange readings. It's like what was on Sepix, but if I didn't know any better, I'd say this stuff is consuming everything around it.
That is Siva. With the proper direction, it could create anything a civilization would need. At least in theory.
Well, that's not the Fallen.
The Hive tend to keep to the dark. Something is driving them into the open.
Now what in the world is that thing? It's like a little drone that's like running around cutting stuff. In the world. It's like the drones are going crazy.
Sensor grid. There's a monitoring station near your location. Hook into it and try to get the grid back online.
No problem.
There's not enough left of the sensor grid to fix.
Wait. We can pull the logs from the monitoring station. Would that be enough to figure out what these fallen are up to?
Do it.
Something weird incoming.
Splicers?
These fallen are different. They're augmented with some sort of technology, like Sepix.
Augmented or not, we need that sensor data.
I don't think I like the new and improved fauna.
They're still fallen, they're just a little tougher. that was an utter miss. Wow. What the hell's that? Almost computer-like.
Got everything I could out of the sensor logs.
Nice job, Guardian. But we still have to deal with Sepix. We no longer need the servitor, Shiro. I've seen enough to know the Fallen have restarted production of SIVA. Guardian, we've established a base at the Iron Temple. Join us here.
Okay. Will do. Right, so that's going to do it for this episode, guys. So, thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this episode or previous episodes, please give a like. If you guys enjoy my Let's Plays, please don't hesitate to subscribe, and I will see you guys in the next episode of Let's Play Destiny Blind. But until then, guys, later.